Hi, I'm Chef Lauren Montalbano, otherwise known as the Vibrant Veg, and I am going to be preparing some excellent plant-based dishes for you today that will help you to look and feel your best. I am a plant-based chef, a holistic nutritionist, and an event and retreat caterer in Madison, Wisconsin. And I love showing people how to make really vibrant, nutritious food that is gonna leave you feeling amazing. So I've got three dishes for you today. We are going to be making a peach and fennel salad with a hemp seed vinaigrette, herbed cashew cheese on a crostini. Then we're going to move on to make some plant cakes with a really flavorful and delicious broccoli, white bean, and kale salad. And then we're going to move into dessert, and I'm going to make a lavender lemon curd with an aquafaba whipped cream and fresh berries. So for our first course, we will be making a salad. I know what you're thinking. This is not your normal salad. We're gonna have lots of flavor, lots of nutrition. If you wanted to, you could eat this salad on its own because it will be that filling, but it's gonna be a part of our three-course meal. So we are going to be making a fennel and peach salad with pickled red onions, a little bit of a crostini with an herbed cashew spread, and some really bright and acidic pickled red onions, and a hemp seed vinaigrette. So to get started, we are going to be making our cashew cheese. So I have had these cashews, they're raw cashews, about 2 cups soaking in hot water for at least 20 minutes. If you've got a little bit weaker of a blender, I would soak them even in boiling water for a little bit longer. So then you are going to take out this liquid and not blend it with that. So we're gonna be removing that, straining it, and adding our cashews right into our blender. Along with, we are going to be adding just a splash, maybe 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, 1/4 cup of nutritional yeast. So nutritional yeast is something that us plant-based eaters add to things to make it taste cheesy. It's a byproduct from brewing beer, and it's packed full of B vitamins, so we really, really like it. 1 tablespoon each of garlic powder and onion powder, again, just to give it some really nice flavor, and then just a pinch of salt. And again, this is all relative. I'm using a Himalayan salt, so that's packed full of vitamins and minerals as well. And then we're going to add probably about 1/4 cup of water just to help it blend. You can also get crazy. You can add fresh garlic into this. You can add Dijon mustard into it. You can really flavor your cheese how you want. A little bit of smoked paprika, depending on the flavor that you're going for. So now we're gonna get rolling and we're gonna turn these nuts into cheese. So depending on your blender, you might have to coerce it to work a little bit. We've got a little bit of an older model here, so we're just going to work with our cashews here, kind of scrape down the side of the bowl, add a little bit more water, and then just keep blending. It's going to try your patience, but you will be better for it in the end. All right, so after a little bit of struggle, we now have nut cheese. So I do tell people the best piece of equipment that they can purchase for themselves is a good blender, also followed by a good food processor. If you want your appliances to do your work for you, they totally will. So this is the base for our cheese. You can use this as is. You can add it to your pastas. You can put it on garlic bread. You can put it on sandwiches, literally anything. But we're gonna zhuzh it up a little bit, and I'm gonna add in some dill. Make it really nice and herb forward. I've got a little bit of thyme here. There's a pun in there somewhere. I don't have it for you right now, but we also have some basil. So any herb that's really in season is gonna be your best bet. We're coming into fall in a little bit here, so I'll usually switch this out and add sage and rosemary, maybe some tarragon. In the spring, I like to use chives. So we're gonna get this all ready for a little chiffonade here. So we are just going to, they like to say you're rolling a cigar. So you've got your little basil leaf cigar here, and then you're just gonna come through as fine as you can. It gets bruised very easily. Its feelings get hurt, it changes color. We don't want that. We want it to maintain its integrity, maintain its color, and just really be bright and flavorful and abundant. So now we have our little chiffonades. We're gonna add that to our herb cheese. Give it a little bit of a mix up here. So you don't wanna add your herbs when you blend it. Otherwise you'll have like a little Dr. Seuss like green cheese situation going on, which you don't want. We just want our herbs to complement in color and flavor. We don't want to make a whole green cheese. Or maybe you do, I don't know, it's your life. So now we've got our cheese, and we are going to go ahead and put this aside while we make our hemp seed vinaigrette for the salad. All right, so now we're going to prepare our vinaigrette. So another just super easy preparation in the blender. So I've got about a quarter cup of hulled hemp hearts. These are amazing sources of protein and omega vitamins. There is about 10 grams of protein just in these 4 tablespoons. We've got 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar. We've got just a splash of maple syrup just for a little bit of added sweetness. And we have some Dijon mustard for just a little bit of punch in there. And then we're going to add about 1/4 cup, 3 tablespoons of water just to help it blend. So this is also a really great oil-free recipe if you're looking to eliminate some extra processed oils from your diet. So as you can see, this is frothed up really quite nicely and made a really creamy vinaigrette for us. We're just gonna give it just one more little pulse. But you can see it's almost the consistency of like a Caesar dressing. So we're just gonna take and pour just a little bit on our greens to give them a little bit of a dress up. And then we're ready to plate. So we're gonna toss our greens and our vinaigrette here. Add them to the bowl. And then we have all of these fun toppings. So we've got a little bit of fennel that I sliced beforehand. Fennel is amazing and I think slightly undervalued. It's really good for your digestion. So it's something great to add to the beginning of your meals because it's gonna help you to digest your food as you're eating. So now we're gonna add our fresh radish. Sort of slice those on a mandolin so they're really thin and you just get a little bit of spice without it being too overwhelming. It is peach season, so it would be a travesty if we did not use peaches because they are excellent right now. And then earlier I pickled some red onions, and these are just a great thing to have on hand all the time. You'll never be sad that you have pickled red onions in your fridge. You add them to anything, it adds color, it adds acidity, it adds vibrancy. It's delicious. And then, even though I mandolined the fennel earlier, we have the fennel frond, and this is often forgotten about and not used, but it makes a really excellent garnish. So you can just take off the frond and just add little pieces. People will think you're so fancy. Do you think I'm fancy? I think I'm fancy. All right, so here is our salad presentation. So then, along with that, we have some beautiful baguette here that we're just going to go ahead and spread this herb cashew cheese on. So instead of doing croutons or something crunchy like that, we have this. It's gonna add a lot of texture. It's gonna be a little bit more filling. And it's really gonna showcase this herbed nut cheese that we made earlier. And we are finished. We've got our fennel and peach salad with herbed cashew cheese and baguette. So for our main attraction, we are going to be making some plant-based crab cakes. So I like to, as you have seen, I like to put a lot of things in everything. It's a lot of diverse nutrition, a lot of flavor. So we have about 2 cups of roasted cremini mushrooms. Again, best friend, food processor. It would take me forever to chop everything that I need for these plant cakes. This is gonna do it for me. We're gonna do about 1 cup of artichoke hearts. You can just, again, it's gonna do my work for me. Dump them right in there. Heart of palm, not a super common ingredient, but you can usually get them at any of your grocery store. And so this is actually, like it says, it is the heart of the palm tree. It has a really fun texture, a fairly neutral flavor, so it lends itself really nicely to these recipes. Then I'm going to go ahead and use some more hemp hearts. You can use sunflower seeds, you can use walnuts, anything to just give it a little bit of tooth, a little bit of bite. Then garlic, probably about 1 tablespoon of garlic will go into here. 2 tablespoons of ground flax. So this is gonna help bind it. It also adds nutrition. It's very high in fiber, very high in omega vitamins. And it's really good for your colon and your digestion. So then we're also going to add in probably about 1/2 cup of chopped onions, a little bit of salt, and then we're just gonna pulse it. It doesn't get more easy than this. So you don't wanna puree it. You just want it to be pretty chunky. And look at that, we're there. So we're just gonna scrape our mixture into a bowl. See how easy that was? What was that? 10 seconds? And we've got this really nice mixture. We're not done though. We are going to add in a little bit of parsley for color. And we're also going to add in about 1/4 cup of panko breadcrumb, just to give it a little bit more texture and help it bind. We're gonna mix this together very gingerly here. You can fry these, but because we are being healthy here, I am just going to put them on a parchment lined bake sheet and bake them in the oven. I've got my oven set to 350 and they're going to bake for about 20 minutes. So now this is where we get fun. We're just gonna like get in here with our hands and start to form these little cakes. You're looking for about 1 palm size here. But again, I'm not here to tell you how to live your life. You can go bigger. If you wanna make this into a burger, enough to fit on a bun, you can do that as well. If you want just little bite-sized poppers, they're great for that as well. So now we have our perfectly formed plant cakes ready to go into the oven. These will go in at 350 for about 20 minutes. Again, it depends a little bit on a convection setting, but it could be anywhere to 27 minutes on the dot. So while we have those cooking, we're just gonna whip up a quick vinaigrette that's going to dress our grain salad to go along with these plant cakes. So this is just gonna come together very simply. All we have is a little bit of oil. I've got some neutral oil, a sunflower oil. You can also use olive oil. So we're gonna do about 1/4 cup of that. We are also going to use sherry vinegar, one of my favorite vinegars. It really packs quite a punch, a lot of acidity, a lot of flavor. So we're gonna do about 3 tablespoons of that. Just a touch of garlic, about 1/2 teaspoon. And then I have some minced shallots here. So we're going to do about 1 tablespoon of minced shallot. And then touch salt. All you do is whisk that together. Again, couldn't be more simple. So this is going to be the base of flavor for our grain salad that we'll be serving along with these plant cakes. So I've pre-roasted some broccoli, and then we are going to add just about 1 handful of kale. This is to make sure we're getting all of our greens, right? Antioxidants are our friends. So it pops with color, it pops with flavor, it pops with nutrition. And then earlier I cooked off some quinoa and I cooked off some cannellini beans. so we've got those over here on the stove. So I'm just going to add in about a cup of quinoa. This portion, fairly large, will feed two people. And then because we always want to make sure we're adding some sort of protein into our meal, we've got these beans. And I'm going to show you something very magical that accompanies cooking your own beans or even buying them in a can. So I have strained these, but I have kept the bean liquid. This bean liquid is referred to as aquafaba. Fancy name, don't know how it got there, but it's the great stuff. So this liquid is very high in natural proteins. So you can use it just like you would use egg whites. So I'm gonna show you how to make an aioli dipping sauce that will accompany your plant cakes. And then we're also gonna take that bean liquid and put it on our dessert. What? Yeah, we're doing that. And we're gonna sweeten it with a little bit of maple syrup and turn it into aquafaba whipped cream. So it would have been a byproduct before. Now it won't, now it's gonna be delicious. So this came together super easy. We're just gonna pour our vinaigrette onto here. You can serve this warm, you can serve it cold, whatever is your preference, especially for the time of year. It's very hot right now. So my vote is cold salad. I like to cook with color. We've got a lot of green going on. We've got a lot of tan going on. So what we're going to do is we're going to fold in some julienne sun-dried tomatoes. This is gonna add also a little bit of sweetness and a little bit of like mouthfeel, some chewiness, and again, some color, vibrancy. That's what we're looking for. So when our plant cakes are done cooking, this will be waiting for us. Now, again, really quick, our best friend, the blender. We are going to make this aioli. So I have half a cup. You can see how thick and viscous this is. When you want it fairly thick, it'll blend really quick. So bean liquid right into the blender. Then we've got about a teaspoon of Dijon. This is gonna help us form that emulsification that we're looking for. That goes right in there. Because I'm not afraid of flavor, we're gonna do a little bit of garlic. And then we're just gonna blend this on low. So now we've made sure that all of the garlic chunks have been blended out of it. So we've got a smooth liquid. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna form the emulsification that is going to make this a very stable situation. So again, we're gonna put this on low and just begin to drizzle in our sunflower oil slowly, and you're gonna see it thicken up. So now, as you can see, we've got a fairly thick cream, our little aioli here. So we're gonna pour that in, and this is gonna thicken a little bit more as it sits. So if you did this ahead of time and put it into the fridge, it would be ready for game time. So I'm also, because again, not afraid of flavor, I'm going to add in some fresh herbs to this aioli. I've got some fresh dill because that flavor goes really well with our crab cakes. We're just gonna fold this in. And this is gonna be ready to go for when our crab cakes are ready. So it's been about 25 minutes and our plant cakes are looking pretty done. So I'm gonna grab those from the oven and then we're gonna plate. I know you guys can't smell this, but they smell pretty good. So you can see they've all kind of stuck together. They're a really nice color. It's gonna complement our dish really well. So again, just like a big hearty scoop of this salad. Put them on the counter too, just for later. And then, gonna have our plant cakes join the party here. And you've got a little bit of sauce on the side, or you can also do a little bit of a drizzle as well. Kind of don't know where it belongs. There we go. Packed full of flavor, packed full of nutrition. You are gonna feel amazing after you eat this dish. now we'll go ahead and start with our dessert. So as I mentioned earlier, we will be making a lemon lavender curd. We'll be making this with coconut milk, though you can use any sort of plant-based milk, lemon juice, maple syrup as a natural sweetener, turmeric for some color and added health benefits, and also a lavender extract and a little bit of cornstarch to help thicken it. So our first step is going to be pouring the coconut milk into a pot. And we are just going to get it a little bit heated up, reserving some of this coconut milk to mix with the cornstarch. So this is gonna be our thickener. Since we're not using eggs like a typical curd, this is gonna help give it that nice thick consistency. So you really wanna make sure that you are whisking everything together. Nobody wants a lumpy curd or lumpy gravy or lumpy anything. Doesn't belong in desserts. So, now we've got this mixed and ready to go. You can see it's a little bit thick, no lumps remaining. And then we're gonna whisk our coconut milk together here. Sort of test it, see if it's hot. It needs just a little bit more time. But once that begins to heat up, we can start to add in our other ingredients. So you don't want to add the lemon juice too early, because as you cook the lemon juice, that flavor is going to decrease, and we really want it to be really bright and profound. So the reason that we're adding turmeric is it's going to give it a lovely sort of lemon curdy color. Again, since we're not using egg yolks, we don't have that color naturally. But turmeric, as we know, is great for a myriad of things. It's an anti-inflammatory, an antiseptic, it's anti-carcinogenic. This is just, it's literally gold in a bottle. And then we've got our lavender extract. You can also use lavender essential oils, and this is a really amazing thing to add to beverages in the evening. It really helps to mellow out the central nervous system. So to have lavender in your dessert, it's just going to give you a wonderful sense of calm, and it tastes amazing as well. So it looks like our coconut milk is doing its thing over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and add in the maple syrup. You can also use agave nectar. Any sort of a liquid sweetener is lovely. And again, it's got a little bit lower glycemic index than just a regular sugar. We're looking to add health benefits here. We're not looking to spike our blood sugar and inflame our bodies or anything with desserts. I like to call it desserts with benefits. We are actually getting healthier by eating dessert, which is an amazing thing. So we've got that in there. I'm gonna add probably about a half a teaspoon of this turmeric powder for color. And you know, you can go a little heavier if you want. You just wanna avoid having that. It's got a very astringent flavor, so we don't want that in our desserts. But you can see it's adding a really lovely color. We're gonna test this. It's getting hot. Give it a little bit more heat. Now we're going to begin to thicken. So you can just pour your thickened coconut milk right into the pot. This is really one of my favorite desserts for spring and summertime. It's really light, it's really fresh. So it's not gonna make you feel heavy. And again, with that added aroma of the lavender. All right. So again, you don't wanna walk away from this project. You wanna just continue to sit and whisk it so that you kind of get a feel for how quickly it's thickening. If you walk away, first of all, you'll wish you hadn't, and second of all, you'll have kind of like a really lumpy, thick dessert, and we're not making rice pudding. So, I'm just gonna just keep on whisking this until that cornstarch begins to set and helps thicken up our mixture. It's going really nicely. And as that's happening, I'll start to think about adding in my lemon juice and think about adding in this extract. We're gonna add about a teaspoon and a half of this extract. If you want to use essential oil, that stuff is very powerful. You'll really only need a drop of it. You can also make this as a lemon bar with pretty much the same recipe, just making yourself a crust. Really easy crust that I like to use is just equal parts of any dried fruit or any nut. So what might go very nicely with this would be like maybe an almond and apricot crust. You just kind of pulse them in the food processor until they begin to stick together. Pat down a pan, a lined pan with it, and then pour this right on top. And then you've got lemon bars. So it's super versatile. If you're really digging it and you want the recipe, you can buy my cookbook. So this cookbook called Grounded can be found on Amazon. I also sell it locally in Wisconsin. It's thickened up quite a bit. So now I'm going to add in my lemon juice. And that just really makes that color pop. So now we're kind of gonna start the process over again. Because I added more liquid, now it's gonna take a little bit more time to thicken once again. But hopefully you can see in this big old pot, it's got a lot of really vibrant color. It's getting a little bit frothy. You do wanna make sure that you get it like a proper thick consistency, otherwise it won't set well for you in the fridge and you'll just be serving people like a weird sort of thick lemonade situation, which you do want. All right, so our consistency is there. So now that we've got it a little bit thicker, I am just gonna add in the final touch and just do, like I said, about a teaspoon and a half. It really just depends on your personal preference and how floral you really want it. It's a flavor that I really enjoy, but not everybody really enjoys. So you don't want the whole thing to taste like you just stuck your head in a bed of lavender. So have yourself some nice presentation cups ready to go. And then you can just kind of pour directly into there, making sure that you don't make a mess of it. Because anything that you leave on the rim will show. You can wipe it afterwards, but I once had somebody tell me the free pour builds character. So remember that as you're doing this, you're building your character. All right, here we go. Look at that, not a drop on the rim. It's like I've done this before. Now these are gonna get popped right into the fridge. They're gonna set, and then I'm gonna show you some really fun toppings to go on top of there. So as promised, we have had yet another purpose for our bean liquid, is I am turning it into a cream that is going to top our dessert. So again, something that would have been wasted is now being repurposed for two separate sauces. Cool stuff. So we have whipped our just plain bean liquid. I'm going to continue whipping it for a minute, add just a little bit of our maple syrup sweetener, and then we're going to use it as a whipped cream to top this dessert. All right, super easy. Look at this. What? It's literally just bean liquid and maple syrup. We're just gonna go a little bit more because why wouldn't you? It's healthy, right? Then garnish, always important. You can do some berries, you can do some mint, anything that gives it color and vibrancy. And then this is our dessert. Thank you so much for joining me today. It was my pleasure to show you a little bit more about how vibrant, nutritious, plant-based food can be. If you liked what you saw, I would love to teach you more. You can find me at thevibrantveg.com, Lauren Montalbano on Instagram, or you can purchase my cookbook on Amazon. So as you can see, you are able to make delicious food that not only tastes good, but helps fuel your health. And you can feel good about it because it's also good for the planet. So if you'd like to learn more, please buy my cookbook on Amazon, visit me on Instagram at Lauren Montalbano, or visit my website at thevibrantveg.com. Be healthy, be well.